Hi my friend, welcome back. The jinn in Egyptian mythology and the truth about Anubis. To make the story more intriguing, we must start from the beginning. Iblis, Satan, refused to prostrate to Adam because he saw a creature weaker than him in physical material. And this is indeed true. Iblis, due to being created from fire, was much stronger than Adam, who was created from clay. However, he did not possess what Adam possessed, and what God distinguished him with over all his creations in the entire universe, which is the complete intellect. There is no creature that God created and endowed with the complete intellect except Adam, peace be upon him. Iblis followed the apparent, as his intelligence is much less than that of Adam, but physically, he is much stronger. In fact, he has a much longer lifespan, and diseases have a very weak impact on him. His physical strength is immense. So how can he prostrate to this extremely weak creature in his eyes? But he did not know that the miracle of the human mind is one of the strongest powers in the universe. And God gave Adam a complete and comprehensive mind that can comprehend all the knowledge of the universe if God willed to teach him everything. And indeed, Adam learned all the names and sciences, and God made his mind constantly receptive and progressive to any knowledge that God bestowed upon him. Therefore, the secret of humanity lies entirely in their minds, which is what they excel in over all of God's creations. Satan was expelled from God's mercy and became an enemy of Adam, and God warned Adam about him. However, Satan was never given authority over Adam due to his physical strength. Instead, a strict set of laws separated the two worlds. No person can penetrate them physically unless under certain conditions through the knowledge and practice of the science of letters and numbers, which is written only with a pen. There is no authority for the world of jinn over humans unless humans allow them to do so through covenants and agreements. These agreements are called contracts between them, and the jinn always aspire to enter and control humans. In this way, jinn have authority over humans when allowed through a contract. Ancient Egyptians were aware of this and knew about the world of jinn, spells, and how to write contracts with loopholes that jinn didn't know about. These loopholes prevent complete control by the jinn when they enter the physical world of humans. Instead, it greatly limits their power. The ancient Egyptians also knew of a chemical substance that prolongs the lifespan of jinn and serves as their food. The intellect of jinn cannot be compared to the intellect of humans. At best, their intelligence is equivalent to that of a 12-year-old child. The ancient Egyptians skillfully wrote contracts, deceiving the jinn with loopholes that prevented their control upon entering the physical world. The jinn would realize that they had fallen into a trap, and humans would become the ones in control. However, due to entering the physical world, the jinn's power diminishes greatly compared to their power in their own world. In the contract, everything is written with great precision by the priest, who skillfully uses their mind to deceive the jinn and use their power to protect the tombs. However, the jinn is confined within the tomb after the completion of the contract, and they cannot escape their confinement. The jinn desires the chemical substance invented by the priests that prolongs the jinn's lifespan and serves as their food during their imprisonment. The jinn is deceived by the cleverness of the priest. That is why a group of specialized priests, skilled in observation, would pass down this knowledge to their children along with the correct method of writing contracts without any loopholes that would allow the jinn to escape or gain authority over the priest themselves. Any mistake would cost the priest their personal life. The jinn aspires to enter the world of humans, which they can only observe and cannot cross into unless granted permission by humans through contracts and agreements. As for the specialized priests, they had specific qualifications and rigorous training for their children to prepare them for dealing with jinn. The child had to be brave and able to control their emotions, as jinn are aware of human fear and interact accordingly. They would train their children from a young age and choose those with the desired qualities. The training involved scorpions and snakes, which are often used as vessels for the jinn when they are requested in the human world. The jinn takes on the characteristics of the body it enters.
Stay tuned for part 2 to learn about who Anubis is and his relationship with the jinn in ancient Egyptian.
We hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video.